Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to manually enter bank and credit card transactions in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. As you learned in the previous lesson, certain transactions must be entered into Xero prior to reconciling your bank and credit card accounts. For example, invoices and bills should be entered prior to reconciling so that you can easily match them up with the corresponding deposit or check transaction downloaded from your bank. In this lesson, we're going to cover transactions that are not related to invoices or bills and thus can be entered prior to or during the reconciliation process. These transactions fall into one of three categories: spend money transactions, receive money transactions, and bank transfers. Let's discuss when to use each transaction and how to record the transaction in Xero. In general, you should use a spend money transaction to record money spent that is not related to a bill, a bank transfer, or an expense claim. To learn how to manage money spent to pay a bill or an expense claim, head over to the previous lesson, How to Reconcile Downloaded Bank and Credit Card Transactions. You can click here to access this lesson. Bank fees, payments made via check, ATM withdrawals, and debit and credit card purchases are just a few of the types of transactions that should be entered as spend money in Xero. For example, if you use the company credit card to buy lunch for the office, this would be a spend money transaction. However, if you used your personal credit card, this would be an expense claim. You can click here to access our How to Manage Expense Claims lesson. Let's go ahead and enter a spend money transaction into Xero. From the Xero dashboard, you want to go ahead and click on the plus sign here right below your name. And then let's go ahead and select spend money. In the next screen, you want to select the bank account that the money was withdrawn from, and then click the next button. And here are the fields that we need to complete to create a spend money transaction. In this first field, we need to let Xero know what type of spend money transaction we want to create. We have the option to choose from direct payment, prepayment, or an overpayment. A direct payment is a payment made for products or services that you received, for example, office supplies, or in this example, parking fees. A prepayment is a payment that you've made in advance of receiving goods or services that you've purchased. For example, a deposit made to secure a caterer for an office party would be a prepayment. Xero allows you to apply the prepayment to a future bill or treat it as a refund if it is a refundable deposit. An overpayment. If you paid more for products or services than you were supposed to, you can enter this transaction and reconcile it to the refund or the credit note that you received from your supplier. So we'll go ahead and select a direct payment. In the to field, you want to go ahead and select the payee from the dropdown or add them if you have not set them up in Xero. In the date field, you want to enter the date of the transaction for the payment that was made. The reference field is an optional field. In this field, you can enter a reference number or any additional information that you'd like to. If the payment was made by check, you could actually enter the check number in this field, and then you'd want to go ahead and mark this box here that says pay by check. Item. If the payment was made to purchase an inventory item, select the item from the drop-down field. If you have not set the item up in inventory, you can do so here by clicking the New Item option here. The Description field will automatically populate if you did select an item here in this field. Otherwise, you can type a description just so that you are aware of what this purchase was for. Enter the quantity of items that you purchased in the Quantity field. If a service was purchased, enter a quantity of one, as we have done in this field, and then go ahead and type in the unit price in the next field here. Account. Select from the dropdown the account that you want to categorize this expense to. To learn more about accounts, check out our How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. Region. Region is a type of tracking category. If you want to track income and expenses by department, location, sales rep, or another method, then you want to select a tracking category from the drop down here. To learn more about how to set up tracking categories, check out the Organization and Financial Settings lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. The amount field will automatically be populated by Xero by taking the quantity column and multiplying it by the unit price that you indicated. This icon up here allows you to attach a scanned copy of a receipt or other documentation to support your transaction. Please note that you can use Xero files to help you stay organized and prepared for tax season. The tax field. From the dropdown, you want to select the appropriate tax rate if applicable. Check out our sales tax lesson to learn more about how to set up, report, and pay sales tax. You can click here to access this lesson. If you purchase something for a customer, you can flag it as a billable item here. Click this link to select the customer that should be billed for this item later on. Last but not least, don't forget to save your work. Once you have saved the transaction, you should receive a notification similar to this one here. Now let's talk about receive money transactions. In general, you should use a receive money transaction to record cash, check, or other deposits not related to an invoice, transfer, or refund. If you receive payment at the same time that you make a sale to a customer, then you would also record a receive money transaction. This is similar to recording a sales receipt in QuickBooks. To learn how to manage money received for an invoice, transfer, or refund, head over to our previous lesson, How to Reconcile Downloaded Bank and Credit Card Transactions. You can click here to access this lesson. Tax refunds, customer deposits, and interest earned are just a few of the types of transactions that should be treated as receive money in Xero. Let's go ahead and enter a receive money transaction. Similar to the spend money transaction, you want to click on the plus sign here again at the top, and this time we'll select receive money. We'll go ahead and select the bank account that we received the money or the deposit into and click next. And here are the fields that we need to complete for a receive money transaction. In this first field, we need to select from the same types of transactions that we did for spend money. We've got direct payment, a prepayment, or an overpayment. So in this situation, a direct payment could be a payment that you've received at the time of a sale that is not related to an open invoice, or perhaps maybe a tax refund that you received, or interest earned from a savings account. A prepayment can be a deposit that you received from a customer for products or services that you will provide sometime in the future. And an overpayment is if a customer happens to overpay you, you can enter this transaction and reconcile it to the refund or the credit note that you send to your customer. So we'll go ahead and enter a prepayment transaction here. In this first field, you want to go ahead and select the customer or supplier contact that you received the payment from. If you have not set them up in Xero, then you can do so in this screen by typing the contact name and selecting New Contact. Be sure to check out our lesson on how to set up customer contacts and suppliers to learn more about how to manage contacts. You can click here to access this lesson. Go ahead and enter the date that you received the money in this field here. The invoice number field will automatically populate if the deposit type is a prepayment or a customer deposit. Please note that this field will not appear for the direct payment or the overpayment selections. The reference field is optional. This is the field where you can enter any additional information, a purchase order number, or any type of reference document information you'd like to include in this field. Branding. Xero will automatically populate this field with the default branding template you have set up for invoices. Please note that this field will only appear if you are recording a prepayment or customer deposit. Description. You want to enter the description of what the deposit was for in this field here. Enter the quantity that was purchased in this field, if applicable. For unit price, you want to enter the unit price or the total amount that you received. The account field allows you to select the account where you want to categorize the expense to. Please note that you should set up a separate account to track customer deposits or prepayments. If you happen to use the default chart of accounts provided by Xero, then the prepayments account is already set up for you. To learn how to add, edit, and delete accounts, check out the How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. For the tax rate field, you want to go ahead and select the appropriate tax rate, if applicable. Check out our sales tax lesson to learn more about how to set up, report, and pay sales tax. You can click here to access this lesson. Region. Region is a tracking category. If you want to track income and expenses by department, location, sales rep, or another method, select the tracking category from the drop-down. To learn more about how to set up tracking categories, check out the Organization and Financial Settings lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. Xero will go ahead and automatically calculate the amount for you in this column. Similar to spend money transactions, you can also attach supporting documentation such as deposit slips or perhaps a copy of that tax refund check to your transactions here. Last but not least, don't forget to save your work. One of the most common transactions that business owners will do is transfer money between business bank accounts. To record a credit card payment in Xero, you would also create a transfer from a bank account to the credit card account that you want to make the payment to. Xero makes it very easy to record transfers and credit card payments between accounts that have bank feeds set up. To record a transfer between bank accounts, let's go ahead and walk through those steps now. Let's go ahead and click on the plus sign, and all the way at the bottom, we've got transfer money. Here are the fields that we need to complete for a transfer money transaction. In the first field, we want to go ahead and select the bank account that you are withdrawing the funds from. And in the two field, we will select the account that we want the money to be transferred to. The date field should be the date that you actually plan to make the transfer with your bank, and then the amount field. It also may be helpful to complete the reference field if the transfer is for a specific purpose. You could also use this field to record the transfer transaction number, should you go ahead and make a transfer online, perhaps with your bank or even via telephone. So once you've completed all of these fields, you can go ahead and move forward with the transfer. And then you should see a transfer successful option here. That wraps up the lesson on how to manually enter bank and credit card transactions in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.